Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_029_DIAB where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. Or, if you don't have access to this file, you can use your own file or just sit down and watch the video. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will open the save drawing as dialog box. If you plan to open this file into earlier version of AutoCAD, go and change the file of type from AutoCAD 2018 to the version that you plan to open the file to. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007 and rename the file to 00_030_DIAB. Click the save button. In this tutorial, we'll continue to model our stairs, but we need to get rid of to hide some of these 3D objects temporarily. That way, it will be easy for us to see the stairwell. To do that, let's create some temporal layers. Go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, and click the Layer Properties. This will bring the Layer Properties Manager. Scroll down and look for the 3D wall. Click on the 3D wall. Set it as a current layer. Now, click the New button. When you do, AutoCAD copy all the properties of that layer. Now, rename this layer to 3D Walls. Press the tab key on your key. Scroll and look for the first floor slab. Select the first floor slab. Click the Set Current button. Now click the New button. AutoCAD copy all the properties of the first floor slab. Now rename this slab to Ground Floor Slab. Press the tab key. Close the Layer Properties Manager. Now go to the Home tab, Layer Panel, and click the Freeze Layer button. Zoom in into this area and select the roof to freeze it. Select the surface, the facer wood, then freeze even the columns. Press Escape to get out of the corner. Now go to the V cube and click the front face. Click on this area and move the window down to create a crossing window selection. Select this object. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to see your selection. Now, go to the quick access toolbar and click the down arrow. Select 3D wall 2. Press escape. You can isolate this wall independently from the bottom wall. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the freeze command. Zoom in into this area and click on this wall. AutoCAD freeze this object. Let's escape to get out of the corner. Now select this slab and orbit. Select this slab. Move this slab to the ground floor slab. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Select these stairs. AutoCAD sets the layer of that stairs as the current stairs. Go to the layer panel again and select the freeze command. Freeze this slab. Press escape. Go to the visual style control and click realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Zoom in into this area and select the slab. Hold down control, shift, and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, click on this vertex. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. At the select object prompt, select the foundation. Press enter. At the select object prompt, select the slab. Press enter. AutoCAD subtract the slab from the foundation. Now go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe. Select realistic. As you can see, AutoCAD subtracts the slab from the foundation, but the slab is now gone. but that is not a problem. Since we copy the slab before we use the subtract command, all you need to do, hold down your control key and type V on your keyboard. As a specify insertion point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap at the vertex of the foundation to place your slab back into place. We need to bring this slab back. So to bring this slab back, go to the Home tab, layer panel, and click the down arrow. Look for the first floor slab. Scroll down and select the first floor slab. Click the tall layer button to bring back the slab. Now select this slab. Go to the Home tab, layer panel, and move this slab to the ground floor slab. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, layer panel, and select the freeze command. Freeze this slab again. Press escape. Remove this slab temporarily to the ground floor layer slab. Select this slab, right click, isolate object. Go to the zoom in into this area. Go to the Home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounding area prompt, select this face. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 6 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select the slab again. Hold down the control, shift, and type letter C on your keyboard. At the prompt, specify base point. Use the endpoint object snap and snap into this vertex. Go to the Home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this wall, press enter, and select this slab. Press enter. AutoCAD subtract the slab from these walls. Now hold down the shift key and type V on your keyboard. At the specified insertion point, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this vertex. Now the slab back in place, but this wall with the slab are no more interfered to each other. If you have your mouse cursor, you see that we have two stairs in this area. The reason being that we copy the original stairs and paste it one step up to get the final stairs. So to eliminate that problem, let's go to the Home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this and this, press enter. AutoCAD convert it into one slab. Now let's switch to the 2D workspace for a moment. Click the down arrow and select drafting and annotation, or go to the status bar and click this arrow. Select drafting and annotation. Now we are in 2D workspace, but we can bring a tab that which have most of the 3D tools that can help us to proceed our model fast. So right click in this area, avoid the mouse cursor to show tabs, and move down. Select the 3D tools. AutoCAD add the 3D tools tab in this workspace. Now go to the Home tab, layer panel, and click the down arrow. Select the first floor slab, tour the first floor slab by clicking this icon. Now we need to draw a reference in this area that can help us to model the railing. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the Home tab, layer panel, and set the cabbage layer as the current layer. Go to the Home tab and click the down arrow next to draw. Select the 3D polyline. At the specifying start point of polyline, click at this vertex, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 9 inches on your keyboard. Move the mouse cursor up and type 6 inches. Press enter. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and use the perpendicular object snap. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. And move the mouse cursor into this slab and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, layer panel, and select the freeze command. Freeze this, the first floor slab. Press escape to get out of the command. Now hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Select this line, the 3D polyline that you just created. Select the slab, the stairs, and these stairs. Right click, isolate objects. Press escape. Now go to the Home tab, draw panel, and start the line command. at the specified start point prompt, start at the endpoint of this line. And move the mouse cursor down until you see snap into this point. Press escape. Now select this line and have your mouse cursor into this grid. Select this line, pull down control key and type number 1 on your keyboard. Scroll down to the property palette and look for the distance. You see the distance is 6 feet 6, so we need a height more than 6 feet 6 to accommodate this slab. 7 feet is okay, so we need to move for, we need to, the distance is 6 feet 6. Close the property palette, go to the layer panel and click the down arrow, select the previous command. AutoCAD brings back the slab. Go to the 3D tools tab and select the press pull command. At the selected object or select bounded area prompt, click on this face. At the specifying height of extrusion prompt, move your mouse cursor and snap into this 3D polyline. Press escape. Now if we cut the slab at this point, the distance from this step is 7 feet. From this step to the slab is 6 feet 6. So we need to go backward one step more. That way we will have a distance from this point to the slab is 7 feet and this point to the slab is 7 feet 6. But you don't want to push all of this face. We need to put a division line from this to separate the face that we want to push and the face that we want it to be to remain at it as it is. To do that, go to the home tab, draw panel and click the down arrow, select the 3D polyline, start the line from this point and use the perpendicular object snap. You can also right click and select perpendicular, snap into this area, move the mouse cursor up and snap. Press escape. Now go to the 3D tools tab and select the press pull command. At the selected object or bounded area prompt, click on this area, move the mouse cursor backward and type 9 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline. At the specified start point prompt, click on this area, move and click on this endpoint, click, continue to click until you come to the end of this slab. Click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the 3D polyline and hit delete on the keyboard and select this slab and go to the home tab layer panel, select the freeze layer button, click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now we know that this red line is our reference. Select this line and erase it. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button, zoom in into this area. We need to complete this gap. Go to the 3D tool tab and select the press pull command. Select this face and move your mouse cursor into this direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tool tab and select the box command. Go to the status bar and turn on the dynamic UCS. The dynamic UCS allow you create an X and Y plan to any face that you have with the mouse cursor. Now we draw our box into this face. So have the mouse cursor into this face. If you see any object snap or endpoint object snap, click. Then try to move the opposite. Then move to the opposite plan. Make sure that your plan cross the bottom of the stairs. Click. And for the height, move down and click. Now hold down your shift key and your middle mouse up button to edit. Go to the visual style control, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D tools tab and select the subtract command. Select these tiers, press enter, and select this solid, press enter. Go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Orbit around the drawing to see the results. Again, we need to complete this area. We need to draw a line parallel to this step. Let's use the auto mode and the dynamic input to complete this task. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Make sure that your auto mode is on and turn the dynamic input on the status bar. If you don't see this icon, click this button and place a check mark next to the dynamic input, the dynamic UCS. Now, move your mouse cursor and hover into this face. This face automatically becomes the X and Y plane. Move slowly into this vertex. When you see the object snap, click. AutoCAD interprets with this face as the X and Y plane. With the help of the audio mode, we can draw the line where we want it to be connected. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape to get out of the panel. Hold the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit around. Zoom in into this area. Go to the status bar and turn off the dynamic UCS. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At the specified first point, click on this vertex. Move the mouse cursor into this area and snap to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to start the line command again. Click on this endpoint, move the mouse cursor down and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the visual style control and click the realistic select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type R for the radius, press enter. Type 0, press enter. Type M, press enter. Now select this line, this line, this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the panel. Select this three line by using a window selection. Type join on the keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD join the line. Now go to the visual side control, select 2D wireframe and change it back to realistic. Orbit around, go to the 3D tools tab, select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude command, select this line, press enter. Now move the mouse cursor, hold down your shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit around. Snap on this vertex. AutoCAD draw the line. But as you can see, the line go beyond the slab. To clear this problem, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the box command. At the specified first corner prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap on this corner. Now at the specified other corner prompt, move the mouse cursor, make sure that the plan cross the stairs at the bottom of this area. Move the mouse cursor, hold down your shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Move the mouse cursor approximately like this and click, then move down and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the subtract command. Select this solid, press enter, and select this solid, press enter. Also can subtract this solid. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the union command. Select the stairs and select this switch, press enter. Alright, I think the stairs is already been corrected and the slab is also be adjusted to the right position. So we'll stop this tutorial at this point. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to build the railing for our stairs. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or any comment or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along with this series or any other tutorial in my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.